Yo, what's good everyone? I'm back with another reaction video, and as you can tell by the title, I am going to be checking out Look At Me, the album by XXXTentacion. I gotta be honest, there are a lot of pros and cons with this album. First of all, it's yet another album, and there isn't really any new music on this project. A lot of it is from his old SoundCloud days, as well as songs off of his first few projects. So that really leads me into the pros. We are actually getting some SoundCloud stuff from X onto streaming platforms, which I have seen done by Peep's team really, really well. They released Hellboy, Crybaby, both Castles 1 and Castles 2, which I really thought was a great idea to just put those on streaming platforms and instead of putting out unfinished songs, continue to put out some of his old music onto the streaming platforms so it's more accessible by a large amount of fans. So I'm glad they're finally starting to do a little bit of that for X with Vice City. And now the first part of this project is full of essentially all SoundCloud songs, which is really cool. As you can tell, the project is about to drop in 1 minute. Like I was saying, the first 11 tracks on this 25 song album are all songs that come from his SoundCloud. So again, I'm glad to see some old classics finally reach streaming platforms. Before I get into it, I just want to say I'm only going to be checking out the first 10 songs because I don't feel like there's much point in checking out the 14 songs after, as those were already released with the other albums, and I'm assuming most people have already listened to them. So without further ado, let's hop into it. First track, Vice City. This was also the first single that they released from his SoundCloud, I believe in like March, maybe February. So I'm going to skip that one. Instead, we're going to go on to Never. This is a beautiful song. So sit back, enjoy. I've already heard all of these songs, so this is going to be a more chill reaction video. Let's go. I'm so glad they released this. Such a beautiful song. One of my favorite X songs.
So you said so, top of one, two. At the catacombs, you and I, do or die. Skies of grace, so you flew a kite. We knew. And I'll take my lifetime, better days. I wanna wait.
Here we go.
It's all I know you can't ever say.
Yeah. Bro, this song is so good. So beautiful. Elegant.
There being such a long intro or outro to the song, so it's kind of cool hearing like the full thing.
Bro, it's beautiful. They must have remastered it. That's the only way I could see the song actually being like 3 minutes and 40 seconds, because I think on SoundCloud it's a lot shorter. I could be wrong though. Like I said, such a beautiful song. Dude was so versatile. He really could do any sound he wanted. That one right there, Never, one of my favorite X songs. Just an entirely different vibe from what he normally does, from what he's usually known for with his aggressive sound. That one just kind of encapsulated all of his versatility, and that bro could actually sing. He could actually make a really good melody. I love the piano throughout that song. That, like I said, is one of my favorite X songs of all time. All right, track 3, Rare. This is an old one too. I love the slowed down samples that he used to use in his songs. And the piano beats.
Find me.
Ay, I'm an asshole with a cash flow. Ay, I got a bad bitch, she got a pretty pussy. Ay, I beat the bitch right. She won't testify if you ask her. I got Molly all in my dick. That's Molly all in my dick. Drum niggas, so when I shoot this shit, they go, ayy. What do you niggas is about? And I slap the fucker, he unconscious. He'll figure fixing to kill niggas to make the bills bigger, he won't find us. And I play my role to get blocked. I'm on home, I'll fly till I'm tired. Burn the fucker, never young the fucker. I'ma lead the body in Dubai, ayy.
It's so interesting hearing how his sound and his lyrics kind of changed over time, from his early stuff being super aggressive to his more mainstream stuff being a lot more cooled down and a lot more like peaceful. So really cool hearing that. This one is a classic for sure. Ski, glad to see him on a next project for, I believe, the first time. He wasn't on 17, he wasn't on Question Mark, he wasn't on Bad Vibes Forever, he wasn't on Skins, so cool to see him actually on a next project that was officially released.
I got work up for me, fuck the house, I hate that fucking lick. Fuck the state and fuck all of them feds, I'm toying with my bitch. I've been going all with 4 Giottas in the fucking whip. I'm gon' fuck your friends, get on your knees and suck my fucking dick. It be like X, you not working hard, you not dropping shit. I've been chopping all my homies, trapping off them sexy shit. Fuck the doctor, that's gon' save me when I cut my fucking heart. Like a new toy, I might try you. Mojo Jojo Groovy Austin Powers. Soul in a bowl, bitch, I will devour. I rain terror upon you fucking cowards. Might wanna feature, but oh my fucking god. Oh my god, for that shit. For that shit,
fuck. I love how they both come in right here.
Oh my god, oh my god, fuck that shit. Fuck that shit. Oh my god, oh my god, fuck that shit. Fuck that shit. Oh my god, oh my god, fuck that shit. Fuck my shot. Oh my god, oh my god, fuck this shit. Oh my god.
So in the official like Instagram post promoting this album, it said like the first 11, or I guess all 24 of these songs were his favorite that he created. I'm not sure how much truth there is to that, but their choices for the first 11 were really, really good. Some songs are very well known, other songs are a little bit more low-key in terms of what his SoundCloud discography consists of. That one right there, very popular, one of my favorites as well. I mean, all 11 of these songs are some of the best in my opinion. This next track is again probably top 5 for me in terms of X songs. Wing Ridden Angel, the sample, the beat.
I slip my eyes, don't say a word. Bottle full of pills, passed out on the curb. Sun brings heat in the chest, falls snow. Loose like a necklace, so my name won't go. I'll too slow, cause I won't understand. Blade for your cries, count a penny for my sins. Wi-Fi's off in the lake, don't stray. Wrist down the river, not a cross, want a blade. Grow your ways, fly away, fly away, fly away. We don't wanna stay, wanna stay, wanna stay.
I know for a fact that a lot of people, this is probably going to be their favorite SoundCloud song that was released to Spotify and Apple Music. I mean, you can just hear by the sample and his delivery that, like, it's a different type of song. I know it touched a lot of people in many different ways. Like, every time I hear the song, I always think about that video where Juice WRLD and Ski Mask and Slump God are in, like, the same room. And then all of a sudden, I think Ski was getting, like, a wing-ridden angel tat or something like that. And then Juice kind of started singing the lyrics, and then they kind of like connected on like a different level.
I
That's that job.
I always think that video is like really cool to look back to see. Like, X was very influential, very versatile as well. Again, this song, similar to Never, is like beautiful, bro. What I was just so happened to be you. Could have finished you being a moment in your shoes. When I think back to the kidney fails, broken promise I failed. I won't deny the hell to grind you walk on. So beautiful. Again, that sample and the piano is different. I don't think X has ever made a song quite like that one. That one always stands out to me. It's so different from every other song that he's ever made. I'll always love that song. I'll always come back to that one for sure. Track 6, King of the Dead. This is another crazy song. They've picked some good songs. I cannot lie. They've picked some good songs. I can't lie about that. You can tell, like, how different the beat selections were on his old music to the music that we heard off of 17 and Question Mark, bro. Just a different, like, eerie vibe. Bro, the bass drop on this one is ridiculous.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Hey. Hey, pick up the pace. L-O-I, find no haze. Indeed, I am pretty. My effort in vain. The needle in my veins. I'm falling asleep. Can't get it dead. I sever your head. When she touch the river, my brain will be fed. I touch the sky. I'm alive to the day. I watch my demons because I'm sad. Oh, I'm not an orphan. Death feeds my importance. Rest without a soul. Many will fall. Feeling my bones. I say again, yeah, oh.
Like all of his old music too, not only were they different to his released albums, but they were all different to each other. Like no two songs sounded the same. I mean, he was versatile from day one, so we lost a true talent for sure.
I'm on my mind, she feeling your eyes. I'm sick, I despise myself again. Tears never come, my body's numb. I feel like a god amongst men. Cut out my eyes, feed me with lies that I will never have to see again. I feed the hate, I feed the truth. I give the pain to the youth. Fuck the devil for your wealth. Pistol chilling on myself. I control my own death. I don't need no fucking help. Fuck the devil for your wealth. Pistol chilling on myself.
Ever remember hearing this at the end of the song too. So they must have remastered some of these songs and put like a little bit of an intro and like outro to them. It's really cool. I like how they did that. His vocal effects on some of these songs are so crazy. So unique. This is beautiful. No way they're going to transition it into the next song though. There's no way. Okay. I didn't think so. Track 7. Failure is not an option. Interlude. See, again, he keeps on proving my point. Like, we heard some singing, we heard some more aggressive rap. Now there, it was borderline like metal screaming, which I always enjoyed. X always kind of going from genre to genre, from sound to sound, always cool to listen to. All right, track 8, I'm Sipping Tea in Your Hood. This was probably the second X song that I've ever listened to. This is what really put me onto X. And ever since I heard this song, I knew that he was going to be a different artist. I knew he was going to blow up. So I'm glad this is finally on streaming platforms. I will definitely have this on every playlist that I have. This is such a good song. Always enjoy listening to it. It puts you in a different mood for sure. I might have to get lit for this one.
Yeah. Yeah. And pull a sip and take it in your heart. Yo, what the fuck is up, you buttercup? Park in that butt, smoking suicide, bloody blood. Pussy boy, you talking shit on Twitter. It ain't not enough. How these pussy niggas knowing that today I had another post. What the fuck you play, bitch? I see your face. Yo, dick on that fucking gun. I love it, right? Yeah. Run.
Still never gets old. I really think that this song would have been perfect for the little revenge EP that they put together before 17, that little compilation album. This would have perfectly fit the vibe for all of those songs. I mean, with Young Brats and Rip Roach and Look At Me, all those songs fit perfectly with this one. This one and Look At Me, in my opinion, were the two songs that really blew him up. So I'm glad this is finally out. Like I said, this is going to be on repeat. All right, track 9. I spoke to the devil in Miami. He said everything would be fine. Again, this is yet another one of his more popular SoundCloud songs. So glad it's coming to light. Again, the piano beats, bro.
I'll be your son. And I'm always with it. Sun don't shine. Tears don't show up. Hurt me now, cause heart's been broke. I hate myself, but it won't show. I constantly lose all my remorse, and it's 10 for the wolf and 3 for the shepherd, and it's 1 for the sheep who led by your leopard. Often gave his perception as a handle of weapon. Took a bite of your apple, give me all you can offer. Now I'm trapped in a changing maze, setting my soul ablaze. Couldn't control the pace, words is going hey. Heartless is reckless, it's this word of a pacifist, a word of a masochist. I'm all for the man, my lord. I spoke to a bad for me. He said he would save me if I gave him one thing he needed. What is this thing I pleaded? Boy, it's the key to even. And as I spoke, my fangs are strong. Taking it back, he smiles and tells me, what you crave will soon be yours. But what I crave is already mine.
Another great song. Another aspect that I like so much about X's old music is the rawness of his vocals and his voice, and I mean, general. Sure, there were a lot of effects, but again, the production wasn't nearly as it was in 17 and Question Mark. So it's always cool hearing where an artist started and how far they got in terms of their sound. I think he used the distorted and rawness of his vocals and the beats in general to his advantage. I mean, that's really what blew him up. That's really what made him the artist that he was and the sound that he had. So again, very nostalgic going back to all of these songs. Track 10, Willy Wonka Was a Child Murderer. Again, this one's another kind of, I wouldn't say underrated, but definitely not nearly as known as some of the other ones. Bro, it's crazy how many times he actually utilized the piano in some of these beats. I don't think I ever realized that before. A lot of pianos almost in all of these songs.
We'll be right back.
probably sound like a broken record, but the versatility that X had was unmatched, in my opinion. I feel like he is probably the most versatile, quote-unquote, rapper of all time, because, in my opinion, he's not really a rapper, he's an artist. He made songs like this, essentially metal. He made songs like Wing-Ridden Angel, very elegant, very beautiful, same with Never. Again, he did so many different things that other artists could probably never even think of, or if they did, couldn't really be successful the way that X was. So, again, cool to see that his versatility is being put on display in yet another project. This one especially is showcasing off his more heavier side, heavy guitars, heavy distorted 808s, heavy drums, and whoever was playing those drums, I'm not too sure, absolutely snapped. I don't know if you guys heard, but whoever it was going crazy. All right, final track that I'm going to be listening to today, Kill Me, Pain From the Jail Phone. Another fairly popular SoundCloud song. I love this one too, bro. I know that quite a few artists do put out like jail phone songs, and I'm gonna be honest, I don't think any other like jail phone call song is more iconic than this one right here. Sure, Bobby Shmurda did a few of his verses from jail. I think YNW Melly probably did a few as well, but this one is just iconic. I felt like whoever produced this did a great job at actually putting a beat and having the right effects on X's voice to kind of make it sound like an actual song. His production was different, very innovative and unique back then. Like I said, I'm not going to check out the rest of the album, as you guys have probably heard Look At Me and Jocelyn Flores, Everybody Dies in Their Own Nightmares, Train Food. So all of these songs have been on the projects that have already been released. I just wanted to check out the newly released SoundCloud classics, and hopefully you guys enjoyed. And that was the first half of Look At Me, the album. Again, I think it's really cool that his team finally put out some of his old SoundCloud classics. I honestly feel like that is the most effective way to release not necessarily posthumous music, because it isn't music created after he died, but music, just the most effective way to put out music from an artist that has passed away in general. I know a lot of people, including myself, weren't the biggest fans of Bad Vibes Forever, because a great majority of those songs were very unfinished, filled in with a bunch of like features from popular rappers. So really cool to hear a lot of these songs for the first time in a long time. I would love to see them put like Ice Hotel and Members Only Volume 1, Volume 2. All of those types of projects would be really cool to hear on streaming platforms. Hopefully they put out more. I know there's like legal issues and whatnot behind putting out SoundCloud tracks, because for the most part their samples aren't cleared. So again, I'm glad that they finally put out these songs. It was very nostalgic listening to them. I enjoyed myself. Hopefully you guys did as well. And yeah, again, RIPX, such a versatile legend. And yeah, if you guys enjoyed, please be sure to leave a like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you want me to react to next in the comments below. And yeah, peace.